most important thing why people want to come to Germany is in order to secure a job. Why not to update your LinkedIn profile as well? Job search visa, which is valid up to 6 months. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be talking about the really important topic. The most important thing why people want to come to Germany is in order to secure a job, or for some people they also want to settle in here, which is good. But for that you really need to know the German language, first thing, and secondly you need to have appropriate skill set. Now, in order to have skill set, you might want to study in a German university. In case you already overqualified, you don't want to study anymore, and you are at a better position in India, especially in IT or in engineering, then you can simply even apply it from India. In this video, I will not be covering about how a student can get a job here, which is a bit easier. I won't say that easier, but compared to applying from India, it is. And for that, I will be making a separate video on how they can get part-time job, full-time job, they can build their CV so that they are being more visible and highlighted to the recruiters. Before I move further, here are some points related to study in Germany. If you opt for studying in Germany, especially the master's degree, in that way you end up buying 3.5 years to look for a job and settle in here in Germany, which is a good deal because you get 2 years to study, which you can also extend. Then you have, after studies, 1.5 year to look for a job. And you will need 8,000 euro per year to manage your expenses. And as a student, I would like to mention that by law you can also work for 20 hours per week, which means you can easily earn 450 euro to 1200 depending on your position, your profile. Now let me give you a short brief on the living cost. Of course, you can watch my video on the cost of living in Germany. I will leave it, the link, in the description box and in the top somewhere here in the corner. So now, you will need 500 to 1000 euro per month. Kindly note that rent is the major expense, which will contribute to 60% of your expenses. So if you end up living in a cheaper place, it will save you a lot. And also it depends on the city where you are living. Also remember, finding accommodation is a challenge in Germany. So be proactive and start doing it well in advance as soon as you know that you will be in Germany. So in average you will need 850 euro, and this is the reason why while you are applying for student visa they ask you for block account. In that account you need 10,236 euro, which later they pay you by Deutsche Bank per month so that you are independent and not taking state help. Now coming to the other aspect, how you can get job, you are qualified enough and skillful, but you're in India and due to some reason you cannot come to Germany to do any course. So in that case I would recommend you that to keep on applying to the German based companies, but at the same time try to learn the German language. So there are four important things if you keep in mind, that even if you're in India you might secure a job in Germany or you end up working in Germany. So now let's get into those four main areas. Bear in mind that whatever recommendation I will be giving you in today's video will be based on the stories being told to me by the people who have came from India and now working here or have moved back to India. Therefore, the most successful way that tops my list is working in India with an international company or German company. In that way, you have possibility of getting transferred internally. This reminds me of people whom I met a couple of months ago that were working on some project with Mahindra and Nokia. According to them, they are being sent to Germany more often. Meaning, once you will be here, you are not only getting exposure of working in this country or getting accustomed to the culture, work ethics, etc., but also you can look for the other opportunities while you are here and working with that company. In that way, once you are here, knowing the do's and don'ts of the work culture and have sufficient skill set already doing a project with another company, this completely shows your eligibility of being at par for another company at that level. Therefore, in order to get into this level, what you could do is that can search for the companies or international brands that are sending people to do some 2 to 3 months or 6 months project abroad and try to get into those firms. So in order to follow this career path, one very simple way is that you can go to LinkedIn, and over there you can follow the companies and can connect to the professionals. You can see the employees that are working over there, and you can then check their profile and see how their journey was, how they came to Germany from India. And of course, you can also reach to them in case of any advice. Hence, I would recommend you, why not to update your LinkedIn profile as well with relevant keywords which help Google search analytics to rank your profile once the recruiters are looking for candidates like you. And since I'm talking about recruitment portals online, I would highly recommend to have profile made on Xing. It's X-I-N-G. It is like a LinkedIn of Germany, where German-based company look for candidates. Also, I will be soon posting a video where international student has secured a job in Germany through the Xing profile. Basically, what has happened was that the company has approached him. Hence, you can see there is two ways in which you can get job. Either you apply and have relevant contacts in the industry, or simply let the recruiter approach you and able to find you if they are looking for someone having similar profile like yours. Because here I would be suggesting you to have relevant contacts in the industry. Definitely, I'm not asking you to spam people going on to Facebook, their social media. You really need to first do your homework. What I mean here is that research about the company, have your own opinion about the strategies and how your skills can provide value to them. Secondly, you can also approach the HR directly to accelerate your CV or to ask what skills are particularly needed for that job profile, and also send them your CV so that they can keep it in their record. Remember that there are thousands of people who are looking for jobs just like you from many other countries. Therefore, you need to show them how you are the cash cow and what is your USP that the company can leverage to be profitable. Then if nothing is helping out, it is the last off you would want to do by sending people emails or message with all the and being very specific in what kind of help you need. If you simply approach them and telling them, I want a job in Germany, come on, nobody will be willing to help you out in that way. You could either approach them by telling that you have such qualification and you have already applied for this company but haven't heard back from them, or something more specific. Now, my third way will be somehow related to the first and second methods. Now that I am telling you to have good contacts in the industry, this also reminds me that if you have some relative or good friends in Germany which knows certain job vacancies will be opening in the near future, then in that case you might want to take the job search visa, which is valid up to 6 months, but definitely I think it's a really short time, because there have been cases that even the student were unable to secure any job within the time period of 1 year. So bear that in mind and make decisions, apply for job search visa accordingly, otherwise it won't be of any relevance. Out of my own personal experience, I would also advise you to grab any opportunities that is not in line with your dream job, because eventually you can progress within the company. Of course, this path is a little difficult and challenging, but you can do it through your hard work and dedication. Besides, I would suggest you to be fully prepared and have some German language speaking abilities as well, so that you are not leaving any stone unturned before you go to Germany. Here I have listed some of the key points related to job seeking visa, and if you can remember and follow these points, then you can have more success. So to begin with, let's start from the pre-arrival. So make sure that you start applying for jobs in advance before your JSV starts, so that you are in Germany at the time of interview. Then, as I have already mentioned, build your profile on LinkedIn or Xing. Then research about your field, company and job profile to develop relevant skills. For example, if your job profile needs proficiency in Excel, Microsoft Excel and B2 level German skills, then prepare for these soft skills and hard skills in India itself. Make sure while you're applying to a German company, especially in the small scale startup, then your CV should be in German language and also in German format. And since finding accommodation is a challenge in Germany due to high demand and low supply of apartments and rooms, therefore plan your accommodation for sure in advance. Also, you might want to check my video on hostel in Germany, where I have outlined all the necessary steps that you need to take in order to find the accommodation. And this room is one of the student room which you get in the hostel. This room costs only 230 euro per month. So now you have a bit of idea about the rent. You can also do the booking with the expensive hotels, and after your visa process is done, you can also cancel it, but make sure that you are doing the bookings with the hotels that are giving you refund on the cancellation. Also make sure that you are carrying some cash in form of coins, notes, then carry forex card or travel card and the credit card, so that you have enough fund when you are in Europe. And you will of course need some coins to buy tickets, tram tickets, train tickets when you will arrive in Germany and you are in the airport and you want to go to your accommodation. Now let's see the process of applying JSV, that is job seeker visa. So firstly, you have to book with your local embassy for appointment. Once you get the appointment and you are there, you have to show your hotel booking or accommodation booking for those 6 months. Then you need to show 4 lakh Indian rupees in your bank account. Also, they will ask you how you managed to save this much amount of money or from where you got it. Then you have to tell them your date of moving to Germany, and it is that day from when your visa will start and you can actually take the flight and can go to Germany. So be careful with the dates. You don't want to waste even a single day. Then they will deposit your passport and your degree certificates, all the originals. And then later you will get the email to collect your passport and all the originals. Then you are done. You got it. Congratulations. Now let's move on to my favorite part, the arrival. And I assume that you have booked your flight. And in case it's your first international flight and you are wondering on the boarding process, then do check my video on flight from India to Germany. And over there I have listed all the process that I went through when I was going from India to Germany. So do watch that. And now let's move on to the arrival key tips. So finally you have arrived in Germany and you are standing at the airport arrivals, and therefore you will need some coins so that you can buy ticket and can take tram or train and go to your accommodation, your city. And then once you are in your room, you collected your keys with the landlord, then make sure that you are having a phone number and a working internet connection. You can simply buy it either from any supermarket, Aldi or Lidl, or from any store like Vodafone, O2, which are the major giant here in terms of telecom network. Then just remember that LinkedIn is good to find jobs for English related, otherwise Zing is good for small scale startups. Then the job portals you can use is StepStones, Monster, Glassdoor. Beside these, I would also like to mention some more important tips. So make sure that you have done a good research on the skills and jobs that are in demand and the profiles that are in shortage in Germany. For example, IT specialist, architecture, scientist, mathematician, interior designers, nursing, mechanical engineering are some of the jobs that are actually having a shortage in Germany, which means that you have more possibility of getting opportunity in these profile. Now, talking about the job market, beside that, you should be aware that 40% of the jobs are filled through employee referral, which means that it gets filled internally by promoting or by reference from any employee. Beside that, there are small medium enterprises that comprises 50% of the German job market, which means that they only work in German language. So here you can see German language is important to apply in those small scale industries or small enterprises. Also, what I have noticed is that the German companies prefer you to have 2 to 5 years of experience. Even as a fresh student, they expect you to have 1 or 2 years of internship or with some experience already, imagine. Beside that, make sure that you mention your local address and phone number on your CV so that the employers know that you are in Germany, and this is the advantage of being on job seeker visa. And also do not forget to mention on your cover letter that you are immediately available to join the job. Beside that, I would recommend you to go out, meet the employers face to face, and attend events such as job fairs. In that way, you have more better impact. Do not forget to make your business card, small business card, which you can actually give it to them while you are having conversation. And in that way, you are easily remembered by them. And also take action in whatever things you came up with during your conversation, which actually I made mistake when I was applying for a job and talking to them. Now, let's talk about some of the applications that you might need on your phone when you will be in Germany. So the first and foremost important thing is to install Google Map, in which you can actually install offline Google Maps so that even if you're not under the internet, you can make your way to your accommodation, to your hostel and to your city. Then you should install AldiTalk in case you're using their SIM card so that you can handle and manage your plans, your talk times, your internet plans on the app. Then make sure you install the local transport like the DB app or RVG app. Then also install some of the events app or follow Germany events, Germany job fairs on Facebook so that you are getting updated with any such type of events and you can go and attend. Now let's assume that you have got the opportunity for interviews. So during the interview, make sure that you are really authentic and honest, which you even need to be on your CV and cover letter, because from there only they actually will ask questions during your interview. And kindly note that your interview might take 2 to 5 rounds, from telephonic interview to Skype and then face to face like a jury round. Then also note that in terms of soft skills, the employees are looking for you as a team player, problem solving, communication, proactive person. So try to enhance and give examples of all these areas as well. So now when you will get the job, you will have two options. So either you convert your job seeker visa into the work permit or into the blue card, depending on the salary and the profile you have been offered. So congratulations, and these are the basic steps. If you follow, then definitely you will land a perfect job. So finally, what I would advise you is that even if you don't have any contacts, relevant connection, then make sure that you know the language really well and have the right skills in which German market lacks, especially if you are in IT, engineering, or even in medicine field. I have seen people here coming either as a student or on apprenticeship in nursing, or they come here simply for some project and was able to secure any other job in the market. And there were some of my subscribers who even got job through job search visa, but they do have some contacts who were living in Germany who told them about such type of vacancy, and it is then when they got it in here. So these were some of the basics for things that you might want to do. Besides, if any of your spouse is able to do one of the 4 things and could make their way here, then you can also come along them on the spouse visa and can then look for a job. To wrap up this video and make it a little less confusing, I have made a checklist which you can find at the end of this video. So in short, you have a goal which needs a plan in order to get success. We'll be right back. that's it. And it's quite late right now, around 12:30. I really apologize in case the lighting is not that good, but I just thought of that this type of content is really what you are looking for and could help you. I hope it did, and if it did, don't forget to subscribe, like my video, share it with someone who might be benefited seeing this content, and leave me comments, say hi, and let me know in from which part of India or world you are watching me. Also, don't forget to tell me, give me feedback on what other type of contents would you like to watch on my channel. Till then, take care. I will see you in my next video. Bye.